picked up golf at 13.
Okay.
But I hadn't really been trying to focus on like the nuance, like the small things, like three putts and not really hitting driver off every hole.
Every hole, yeah.
You have to go to college to get to the NFL, and I think I'd be wrong to tell you like I didn't want to play top level, right? So I don't know, it kind of just all happened, man. Again, I told you I wasn't the biggest guy on my teams growing up, yeah. And then I got to high school and all of a sudden I was given a lot of responsibility to play quarterback for our team, and really I didn't want to play quarterback.
Yeah.
But you know, that's where the unselfishness comes in, where, you know, all right, we want to win, let's put our best players at these positions, because right. In football, you know, it takes 11 people to do well. And I know with golf, it's all individual and you can't blame anybody else.
Right.
I mean, maybe you can put it on your caddy a little bit, but, but for football, I mean, it's different. It's a different sport, but as far as competing goes, it's the same across the board for all sports, and making sure you're doing your best and pulling your, what I say, your 111. Years old. I believed in what the program had and where we were going. The coaching staff that I committed to was with me during my collegiate years for two seasons. And they're back now. So Coach Rocky Long and Danny Gonzalez and company are back. And what I, again, just going back, they were sending guys to the NFL. They had 3-4 guys go to the NFL when I was in high school, and when I got to college, 2 guys, I'm talking receiver-wise,
right.
My position, Hank Basket, Travis Brown, and Marcus Smith, those guys were the guys I looked up to when I was in high school, like, hey man, I want to be one of these guys.
Yeah.
And so those guys were going to the NFL, and I was like, hey, I could stay home, I have a lot of family here, obviously. It just felt right for me, and I, you know, looking back, like I wouldn't change it. The only thing I would change is that I wish our coaches would have stayed around. Starting to learn, man.
So it started at 13. How did you get involved?
My dad and a couple of high school coaches were like, hey, let's go play. You know, we just go play like Los Altos executive or whatever. And I honestly, man, I just got my new used clubs this last summer.
Sweet.
From Golf Mart, and I'm like, I've always had somebody give me their old clubs, or
right.
Or somebody's like, hey man, I'm done with golf, like, here you go. Like, so again, this last year and a half, I kind of taken it more serious. And then with my job, I have the luxury to take people out golfing, and you know, business goes down the golf course kind of thing. And
absolutely.
It's when you're out on a golf course with somebody for 4 hours that you've never met before, you
right.
learn a lot about them.
You learn a whole lot.
Yeah. I'm an area sales manager for Gen X Services.
Okay.
We're based out of PA, and we've been around for 35 years, and I've been with this company for 2 years, and I cover 3 states, and obviously with COVID, I'm not going anywhere. I'm not
right.
going to Colorado or Utah, which is awesome, because my market out there, they would have their golf tournaments for the industry events.
Right,
and
right.
I got to play courses that I never thought I'd get to play, man. Like Bear Dance in Colorado, Fossil Trace out there, Arrowhead.
That's awesome.
And all these golf courses in Colorado are awesome, man. And on top of that, I get to go work, man, and, you know, meet these people and take decision makers out and try to build those relationships. And everybody knows who we are, but
right.
I'm the face of our company in my state, so it's right. kind of, it's cool to have the opportunity to go and network with these people and play golf. Like, identity, finding your identity after sports, I can be honest with you, it took me a while to kind of figure out who I am, because
right.
when you play in a specific sport for so long, from 8 to 22, like, I was Mike the football player, you know, Mike the athlete. Now it's like, okay, Mike at 32, who am I? Well, I'm a dad, I'm a husband, And I would like to find where that is. Like, you can't, it's a big void, right? So sports is always gonna be in my heart. And I like that I can pick up a golf club and compete, not only against myself, but I can beat my buddies up
right.
on the course and get a little bit of adrenaline rush, you know, especially if it's close at the end, you know, and you got a two shot lead and somebody, there's just many elements to golf, man. That you do feel a little bit pressured. And I always say, hey man, imagine you're trying to make this putt for like $1 million,
right?
You're like, I'm playing for $5, and it's the pressure's like, it's up there, you know?
Right, you don't want to give your buddy that $5.
No, you don't. Sure. You don't want to do it.
And you have a couple of your long bomb drives. What's your furthest?
I'm over 330. I don't know, the carry is probably 310, but with some roll. But there's some good drives, man. We played a lot of scramble tournaments during this COVID time, it was great to just kind of have some normalcy this year.
Right.
18 at, New Mexico Tech on 18, drove it, and we missed the eagle. We missed the eagle, wow. Man. It's like from me to you, dude, we missed it. But we took third. We should have made that, man. We would have won the whole thing. Yeah, I'm a big scramble guy right now. I haven't been in any tournaments individually wise, but I think that's my goal for the next couple years, to kind of just go see where I'm at and just compete again, you know? And
what's your lowest round?
This year is at 85, but that was at like Los Altos. Hey, and
you gotta hit the ball, right?
You gotta hit it, so. But I'm like a 15 handicap, so.
Okay.
I probably started this summer in the 20s, 24. Yeah. Well, it's getting down a little bit, but at the same time, like, there's a lot of things I need to work on for sure. Like the three putts, that's a big one. And then not really getting the driver off the box every time, like I said, like
playing smart.
Just trying to play smart, man. Par five, all you need is what 130 shot, and you're gonna hit par at least.
Rapid fire questions. First answer comes to mind. I like this question, the New Mexico question. Red or green?
Christmas.
Love it. Love it, love it.
Christmas.
Favorite breakfast burrito spot?
Oh, GoPro.
Golden Pride.
GoPro. Number 9.
Number 9, look at that.
But it's green.
Okay.
No Christmas on the burrito.
No Christmas on the burrito.
Let's ask you a question.
Favorite golf hole in out of all the golf courses you play?
It's funny, man. I like par 3s, but the par 3, I think it's number 3 at Paco.
Okay.
Three tier? Is that
number 3? But the 100-yard green,
it's like, it can be 200 yards or
right
here.
Yeah. That's a fun play.
I think it's fun.
So when you're out playing with your buddies, what do you normally play? What games do you play?
Sometimes we'll do some scans. We'll do straight up overall score. A couple times we did best score partners for the hole, but really just trying to just compete no matter what, you know? It doesn't really matter. We get out.
Who do you normally play golf with? Favorite buddies? I want to say
the guys that I play with most frequently. Jargens, Jesus Carmona, and then the fourth one's kind of up in the air. But Jack Donald's been out there a few times with us, and Jordan Marks been out there. But it's consistent group of guys, you know, I know what we're gonna get. It's not like I don't know what these guys are gonna shoot, so it's always fun. A lot of trash talking.
That's the best. Have anything going on in your life you want to promote? What's happening?
I just want to say, you know, thank you for having me, man. Obviously, we're trying to grow the game of golf, not only in New Mexico, but across the world. my daughter's gonna be six in a couple weeks, and she's got her own set of clubs. And for me and her, she asked me when can we go hit balls. So it's kind of, it's cool that she wants to come out. It's no pressure, and I don't want to put any pressure on my kiddo. And golf is a very, if you want to challenge yourself, just come out and just hit some golf balls. You know, hit a bucket of balls. If you want to decompress some stress, come hit a bucket of golf balls. And if you want to get frustrated really fast, come pick up a bucket of golf balls. But I think for a mental state for me, and again, we talked about it, is you get to compete. And if I, you know, got a bucket of 50 balls and I challenge myself, hey, I want to hit, you know, 2/3 of these within the, you know, you give yourself some boundaries, but you know, you can make everything a challenge and kind of see where you're at. Even if you don't have time to go hit golf balls, you can still go putt in the house. You know, you can do things to kind of help elevate your game. I don't know how many hours of YouTube I watched this whole pandemic on like, hey, how do I fix a slice, or how do I minimize 3 putts, or just right. Even watching golf to begin with, you know, like, I think the one thing that kind of checked me a little bit or kept me grounded is like, not grounded, but just watching Tiger Woods and who was it? Tiger Woods, and you had Peyton Manning and right. Tom Brady and Phil. And when you see Tom Brady like slicing off the box and whatever, and then you see him drain like, what was it, 180-yard shot?
Yeah.
He was playing terrible, and that one shot, like, that's the one shot that we all, he's normal like us, you know?
Right.
That's the one shot that'll bring you back, you know? So it's fun to see those guys. Thanks again, man. I really did enjoy it.
Absolutely. I mean, it was a pleasure. Thank you for doing this.
Ooh. Yeah.
Feeling it. Feeling it.
Yep.